Congressman, I mean, frankly speaking, it's fair to say that President Duterte is the one who's shown the most or reached out the most when it comes to the CPP-NPA in his very short term for now, no? Mm-hmm. I mean, mm-hmm. he's put two left-leaning in his cabinet as secretaries. That's one. He's released political detainees. Yeah. And yet, you know, doesn't Secretary Lorenzana frankly have a point that the CPP-NPA are insincere? The government has reached out, you know, given a hand, they wanted the arm, and they've done it. Isn't it time for the CPP-NPA now to show good faith?
Well, first of all, precisely because of those circumstances which you mentioned of the president, I'd like to believe that the communication lines haven't really been cut off, because you still have people in his cabinet, no, who are connected to the left. Yeah. No, Secretary Maza is there, and quite a number of
Secretaries. Or even Secretary Bello, he's sympathetic.
Yes, yeah. Yes. And there is that personal connection between Joma and the president. No, kaya nga, our resolution is an appeal to the president. Mm-hmm. No, no. Possible.
What, to be the bigger person? To be the more patient?
Mahal na araw, we're contemplating about sacrifice and love for humanity. So I think perhaps the president, no, has been known to make sudden decisions. May surprise us,
yeah.
No, this Lenten season, and say, okay, I'm willing to sacrifice a little of my ego, you know, despite the acrimonious exchange between Joma and the president. Maybe that's just rhetoric, but I think at the end of the day, they'd like to have that legacy of peace, no? And as I've said, it's really between the president and Joma.